everyone, and welcome back to another week of Jubilee Kids. I hope you're all well. It's been really fantastic this week to receive some of your pictures and photos that you've taken to remind you about God's amazing creation. Have a look at these. Your love reaches to the heavens. Your faithfulness stretches to the skies. And do please keep sending these in over the next couple of weeks, because we'd love to put them all together to show to the church at the end of this series. Well done to Sarah Hope and Libby Berg, and Abby and Noah Chitsiki and Anne Simpkins for getting the Spot the Difference right last week. The rainbow moved. There it is. Now, if you're wondering who Anne Simpkins is, she's my mum, and she lives in England and she watches every week. Hi, Mum. Now, I wonder if you remember how many psalms there are in the Bible. Can you remember? That's right, 150. That's a lot, isn't it? Now, today we're going to look at one of those psalms. And it's this one. No, not that one. It's this one. No, not that one. No, not that one. Oh, yeah, that's it. It's that one. Psalm 23. It's a very well-known one. Some of you may know already. And because you're getting so good at your memory verses, we thought that you can probably manage more than one verse this week. So we're going to challenge you with three verses, and it's the first three verses of Psalm 23. In fact, over the next 3 weeks, we're going to challenge you to see if you can learn all six verses of Psalm 23. Wouldn't that be amazing? And then it will be in your heart for the rest of your life. But for now, we have Nala and Tiolo coming to help us learn the first three verses, along with some sign language. So have a look at this.
Psalm 23, verse 1-3. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He takes me to green fields where I can rest. He leads me to streams of water where I can drink. He gives me new strength in my life. He is my guide to the right path. He does this to show that he is good.
Wasn't that fantastic? Thanks so much, Nala and Tiolo. Now we're going to go over to do some worship. So why don't you get off your couches and come and dance and sing along with us.
You reach out to save us. feeling all stretched now? I hope so. Let's go over to Kaylin for the introduction to our story.
Hey everyone, I hope you had a good week. My name is Kaylin and I would like to play a quick game with you. Are you ready? I can't hear you. Okay, cool. Our game is called What Am I? I have five characters and you need to guess what their jobs are after I give you a few clues. Let's go. I drive around in a truck and I put out fires. What am I? I protect people from crime and put bad guys in jail. What am I? I look after lots of animals and I grow food. What am I? I tell people what is wrong with them and make them feel better. What am I? I write on the board to help you learn and tell people about the world. What am I? Well done on guessing all those jobs. Now, can you tell me what all these jobs have in common? That's correct. They all involve helping, caring and looking after people or animals. Today's Bible lesson is a song about a shepherd and how he looks after his sheep.
Hello, fellow investigators and adventurers. My name is Elsa and I serve at Jubilee Kloof Street. And today we're all going on an adventure. Can you say it with me? Adventure. And on today's adventure, we are going to ask ourselves two questions. The one is, what is our God like? And the second one is, what does he do for us? I hope you can help me answer those questions, friends. Okay, so the first part of our adventure, I'm going to read the first part of our scripture. And that is, the Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. So I wonder who of you know what a shepherd is and what a shepherd does. If you know, just quietly say it to someone next to you. So what I know about shepherds is that they actually guide and care for their sheep. And so they actually go and live with their sheep in the wild. They make sure their sheep has food, they make sure their sheep has water, they make sure the sheep doesn't wander off. Go, run little sheep. They make sure they don't run wander off. And they just generally care for their sheep and love their sheep. And that is the cool thing about God, because that's exactly what he does for us. He loves and protects us. And the second part says that I have everything I need. The cool thing is that God knows what I need, and it may not be sweeties and coffee, but he really knows what I need deep down inside, and he provides for those things.
We are going to go on an adventure in the mountains. What do you think we need to take with us? Do you think I need all these things with me for my walk in the mountains?
I don't know if those are things I need or things I want. But the cool thing is, I saw when I woke up this morning that someone had packed me a backpack. And in that backpack, I think, are the things that I need. I hope you can give me advice on this. But there was water in. I don't know, do you think I need water? Meh. And there was some fruit. I don't know if I need fruit, but okay. And there was this, I don't know what we're supposed to do with this thing. I think this is for shelter. So I'll just put this over my head like this.
He makes me lie down in green pastures. He guides me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. So as you can see, we're on our bear adventure. And we are at a stream with quiet waters, which is really lovely. And all this green, some green around me. And I don't know what you think it means. What do you think it means when the Bible says that God makes us lie down in green pastures and leads us beside quiet waters? Just think for a moment what you think it means. So what I think it means is that Jesus will help us to find peace in crazy circumstances. And when we're worried or angry or anxious, he is the one that refreshes our souls, that gives us peace on the inside, in our hearts. So the next time when everyone in your house is running around and you haven't done your school tasks for the day and everyone is just crazy and you just feel like you need a quiet space, just ask Jesus to come and fill you with his peace and to actually take you to a place in your own heart where there are still waters and green pastures. And I promise he will do that, because that's the type of God that he is. Guys, I have no idea where to go, literally. Like, can anyone help me, please? Because we've been here for 3 days now and I have no idea which one of these is my path. Whew, I don't know how we're gonna get out of this, but the cool thing is that God says in his word that he guides us along the right paths for his name's sake. And that for me is amazing, that we have to make so many choices in a day, going on literally the right path, or who to be friends with, or what things to say to our parents, or one day what to go study, or what to go do with your life. We have so many choices. But the wonderful thing is, because we have the Holy Spirit with us, he really guides us along the right paths, and he teaches us which ways to go. And he does that so that God's name could be glorified on this earth. So when you listen to him, when you pray and you ask him, Holy Spirit, which path should I take? He uses his word, the Bible, to answer us. And even just whispering into our own hearts what the right choice is for us. So you can do that today. You can ask him, Holy Spirit, show me through your word and through people that I know love Jesus as well, what path should I take? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna ask my cameraman, I know you love Jesus, can you help me to which path should we take now? Can you help me? This one. Thank you very much, cameraman. Hi guys, thank you for coming with me on my adventure. I had a lot of fun and I hope you did too. So remember at the beginning of our story, I asked you two questions. One is, what is our God like? And the second one is, what does he do for us? So just take a moment and discuss those two questions, the answers to those two questions with your moms and dads. Remember, we were at three places. We were in my home when I packed my things, and when it was packed for me. And the second place was, we were on the bridge by the still waters. And the third place is, we were at that signpost where I had no idea where to go. So just pause the video and discuss, what is our God like and what does he do for us? Okay, so I hope you had a lovely discussion. And some of the things that our God is like is, he is like our shepherd. He guides us and he cares for us, like, because we are his sheep. Bah. And what does he do for us? He leads us beside still waters. He gives us peace and he cares for us. He gives us everything we need and he also guides us along the right paths. Okay, I hope you guys had a lot of fun with me today. I had a lot of fun.
Thanks so much to Kaylin and Elsa for all those amazing things they've taught us about Psalm 23 and our shepherd. Now, I have got a challenge for you this week. I would love you to have a go at trying to write your own song to God. Now, that might sound a bit scary or a bit tricky. So to show you that it's quite easy, I had a go with some children during the week on Zoom. Have a look and see what we got up to.
But I thought what you could do is try and help me write your own one. Are you up for that? You're gonna try and give me your own ideas, okay? Because all a psalm really is talking to God and telling him what we feel and telling him what we think about him. So I think you're all clever enough to help me. It says, Lord, you are. Can you see that? Lord, you are. So if you were talking to God and you wanted to say, Lord, you are, what words would you use?
What would you say?
Grace.
Grace.
Lovable.
What was yours, Les?
Lovable.
Lovable. Lovable. I love that one. Lord, you are great. Lord, you are lovable. Lord,
strong.
You are strong. Lord, you are great, mighty. Wow,
courageous.
You're good at the courageous. Brilliant.
Kind.
So, Lord, you are, what was yours, Noah?
Kind.
Kind. I love that one. All those words. So there you go. You've written your first line of your song to God.
You made the...
Okay, you're talking
you
to God.
The,
you made
world.
The...
World.
World. Earth.
You, trees.
Trees.
Flowers.
Flowers.
You, cat. Houses.
Grass.
Grass.
Cats.
You made the...
People.
People.
Cats.
Sky.
What was yours, Abby?
Sky.
Made the sky, definitely. The sky was one of the first things God made.
Thank you for...
Luke, your turn. What would you like to say thank you to God for?
Thank you for the things we drink and eat.
Brilliant. Well done.
My family.
Your family.
Help me too.
Joe, you can start this time. Help me too.
Do the right thing.
Brilliant one. We really need help with that, don't we? Noah, what's yours?
Help me to not be scared.
Brilliant one. I think that's a really important one, especially at the moment, isn't it? Seth, what's yours?
Don't have nightmares.
That's true. I definitely hope that God will help you not to have nightmares.
Thank you.
Yay. Bye. It was lovely to see your faces.
Bye.
So there you go. Those children could do it by coming up with their own ideas. Maybe you'd like to finish one of these sentences like we did. Lord, you are. You made the. Thank you for. Help me to. And you could finish those sentences in any way you like. Here's a picture of Seth with the psalm that he wrote with his mummy after joining us on Zoom. So please do send us in anything that you write or say. Ask your mums and dads to write it down for you. We'd love to see it and put it together into our big Jubilee Kids psalm. So we won't be meeting next week because the Jubilee Kids team are having a break. But this might give you the chance to go back and watch a video you've missed or one of your favourite ones again. And we'll be sending your mums and dads some ideas of other things that you can watch too, all based around Psalm 23. So have a great couple of weeks. Keep warm and we'll see you on the 28th of June when we're going to have lots of fun with some new lessons. Take care. Bye.